Hello, we are the SpaceX fans and welcome to the SpaceX Show, the place where you can stay up to date with everything SpaceX. On Sunday, SpaceX successfully launched their 63rd Falcon mission of the year with the launch of Starlink 10-2.
One, ignition, engine full power, and liftoff. Go Starlink, go Falcon.
The booster which launched this mission, B1078, then landed successfully for the 11th time on the drone ship a shortfall of gravitas.
Stage 1, landing leg deploy. Stage 2, FTS has saved.
Then, the following day, SpaceX successfully launched their 64th Falcon mission of the year with the launch of Starlink 9-2.
1, ignition. And liftoff, Falcon 9. Go SpaceX, go direct to self.
The booster which launched this mission, B1075, then landed successfully for the 11th time on the drone ship Of Course I Still Love You.
Stage 2 in terminal guidance.
Landing leg deploy. Stage 1 landing confirmed.
Then yesterday, SpaceX successfully launched their 65th Falcon mission of the year with the launch of Goes You.
1.
Goes You.
Liftoff of Goes You, NOAA's newest weather satellite, to monitor the Earth and Sun in high definition.
The boosters which launched this mission, B1072 and B1086, both landed successfully for the first time on the landing pads at LZ1 and LZ2, respectively.
Wow, look at that. As it guides its way back down. Woo! Just heard the two sonic booms here in the room.
EYNY landing light deploy.
Our monitor's shaking. That as we watch amazing. These two
that
boosters
is just
land.
Awesome to see the two side boosters choreograph their way down to landing zone 1 and 2.
EYNY landing.
SpaceX posted some cool information about fairing reuse in relation to the first Starlink mission we saw. They said fairing separation confirmed. Today's mission marks our first 20th flight of a fairing half. Related to the Falcon Heavy launch, SpaceX posted saying 10th liftoff of Falcon Heavy. This week, we can still expect to see a bunch more missions launch. The next launch, the Starlink 10-3 mission, is currently scheduled for tomorrow, Thursday 27th at 11:14 a.m. UTC or 7:14 a.m. EST. A couple of days later and we can hopefully expect another customer launch. The NROL 186 mission is currently scheduled for Saturday 29th at 3:14 a.m. UTC or Friday 28th at 11:14 p.m. EST. Then, the following day, and we can hopefully expect another Starlink launch. The Starlink 8-9 mission is currently scheduled for Sunday 30th at 7:11 a.m. UTC or 3:11 a.m. EST. Heading to Boca Chica, the old tank farm tank scrapping is continuing. The final tank shell was also seen removed. This final cryo shell was also seen being scrapped. Concrete was seen being poured for the Pad B launch tower base. The crane to stack the second orbital launch tower continues to be assembled. Work was seen going on with the Pad B tower sections. Everyday Astronaut posted a response to a video of loads of Raptors from his Starbase tour with Elon Musk. He said it's also just incredible how many they are building. People laughed when Elon said they'd be building one a day. Musk responded and said we could build a lot more, but the next version of Raptor is really the one to scale up production. We begin testing it in McGregor within a week or so. Regenerative cooling and secondary flow paths have been made integral to the whole engine, thus no heat shield is required. Taking away the engine heat shields also removes the need for 10 plus tons of fire suppression behind the engine heat shield as any gas leaks simply enter the already superheated plasma surrounding the engines, rendering the leaks irrelevant. Raptor 3 also has higher thrust than ISP. SpaceX recently lifted the B14.1 test tank onto the orbital launch mount. The B14.1 test tank will be used for chopstick catch testing. The work on replacing Starship 30's heat shield tiles has been continuing. Here you can see the new ablative layer being fitted. Finishing up the video today, the closure on Tuesday was revoked, but SpaceX have a closure scheduled for today, Wednesday 26, and a possible closure tomorrow, Thursday 27. Additionally, SpaceX also have temporary closures for today, Wednesday 26, tomorrow, Thursday 27, and Friday 28. As always, I have to say thanks to both Mary, otherwise known as Boca Chica Gal, and Sean Doherty for being out there filming the Starbase content. Also, thanks to the NASA spaceflight team working behind the scenes on their videos, live streams, and other space content. That's it for this episode of the SpaceX Show. I hope you enjoyed the video. If you did, make sure to hit the like button and leave a comment down below. If you want to stay updated with SpaceX info, make sure to subscribe and press the bell icon to get notified when I upload. Thanks for watching and have a great day.